This man is controlled by tiny people living inside him. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe. Smash that like button, and ding that notification bell. At the beginning of the film, a lightning object is shown approaching the Earth. A young Josh was also watching it through his telescope, and the ball quickly fell into a fishbowl in that boy's house. It quickly absorbs the water. Surprisingly, Josh was noticing it. In the next scene of the film, 3 months have passed. The ball is shown again as it approaches the Earth. This was a much larger fireball than the previous one and crashed into the water near Liberty Island. As the fire burns away, the ball appears to be a man in a white suit. The man walks into the city in an unusual manner. All were seeing him strangely. He collides with a car while crossing a road. But he didn't do any harm, he just folded his feet weirdly. The man disappears as the car driver comes out to rescue him. Later, he stands at a deserted place. His ear opens like a gate. A tiny man appears from it and the man reaches the man's legs with a rope. There was a small gate. The man opens it with a nerdy button. He finds many defective wires there. The tiny man starts repairing the wire of the leg. The man was controlling the leg that goes to the brain. Seeing all of this, we realize this is not a man or an alien, but a complete spaceship. 100 tiny humanoids were controlling it. This crew was introduced with numbers in the film. Crew member 1 is the captain of this ship. Crew member number 2 is the captain's assistant. He will be seen as the captain in the future. Crew member number 3 is the system in charge here. The ship's captain controls it with the command ship. There were tiny aliens to control each body part. And they report everything to the captain. The captain was told in the report that due to the accident that ship is not working. But according to the 2.3 days of the Earth, this ship will be repaired. The tracking system of the ship was also damaged. The captain calls the crew members for the meeting. They came from the planet Nil, we discovered. The shortage of the resources their planet was about to destroy. They need salt and water from the Earth. Due to it, they can save their planet. That is why they come from the planet to collect water and salt from the Earth's balls. They have lost it. The ball which we have seen with Joshua, the name of the ball was Orb. They come here in search of the ball. The salt from the Earth can give energy to the Nil planet for years. That's why they decide to come to Earth. Josh notices the human-like ship from his window. He calls his mother whose car collided with the ship. They come to the ship and the lady apologizes to the ship. Aliens get panicked seeing them. No doubt the ship looks like a human from outside, but the aliens don't know this. How to behave like humans. They were about to talk with humans for the first time. They take Google's help for this. They will know about humans' behavior and it will be easy for them to talk to them. The captain of the human ship tries to talk to the lady as a human. The police officers are shown trying to search for the mysterious ball. They go to the place where that ship was landed. At the crash site, they find someone's facial expression. Do they discover how he looks? All the city was trying to search for him. The human ship was trying to talk to that lady. Things break all the ships as it tries to communicate with them due to the high frequency. For setting the frequency, the ship says to the lady, "I'm okay." The lady invites the ship to home after sending Josh to school. The ship's captain introduces itself with the name Dave. They have searched for the name from Google. Now we will call the ship Dave and the movie. From Dave's eyes, the ship members see Josh's picture, in which they notice their lost ball Orb. Josh's mother tells the ship, Josh has shown this ball in his science exhibition. The ship traces the location of Joshua. Dave excuses himself and walks away. Crew member number 2 was controlling Dave's movement. He used to be enraged by people. Because on one follows the rules and regulations in this place. Everyone was going against the rules and regulations. Their commander requests the duster keep an eye on member number 2 while observing his rage. Dave was moving from the front of the park. The kids consider him the ice cream man. Dave goes to a mall to change his clothes. Now he needs money to buy clothes. He scans the money with the help of his hand scanner. He takes out the same prints in the dressing room. Dave goes to Josh's school. The principal considers him a teacher and sends him to the class. Dave asks Josh, where is the ball Orb? He says some evil boys of his class have taken that ball from him. Josh takes Dave to that boy's home. They didn't find the boy there. They return to Josh's home. Josh feels good while spending time with Joshua. Meanwhile, Josh's mother stops Dave for dinner. The ship's captain accepts this. Because there was danger outside for him. Crew member 4 informs the captain that he will stop here for the time being. The risk of the ship's exposure will rise. But the captain ignored it, and now they were showing their home to Dave after dinner. Dave notices a painting there. Dave admires it. The lady says this painting shows love and emotion. Dave questions her, how do we discover love? She replies, whenever it happens, we discover it already. Dave gets shocked hearing this. Then he leaves. Dave decides to spend a night on the road. A man hands him a shawl to keep him warm in the cold. Dave's captain becomes impressed by this. Because of how kind the humans are, the aliens realize that humans are more advanced than them. The ship stays here for a night, Dave sleeps. Inside Dave, the captain tells the doctor, there are some abnormal behaviors that appear in the ship. After it, the captain goes to the control room and notices crew member number 3 is still working. She tells the captain she has searched the file, humans saw this once in their life. It was an American emotional movie. The captain and number 3 watched the movie and were weeping at that movie's end. After it, the captain and number 3 moved to sleep. Dave's battery was only 20% charged the next morning. The police were searching for him. Dave goes to the park with Joshua after a train ride. He participates in the hot dog eating competition. After winning the competition, he gives the soft toy to Josh's mother. Dave notices some kids bullying Josh as he walks out of there. Dave turns to give them the punishment. They find the orb means the aliens' ball. Due to it, Dave means the ship aliens become happy. Dave invites Josh's family for dinner. To celebrate Josh's mother's birthday, but crew member 2 disagrees with the captain on it. He says we should work on our mission if we have got Ork. But the captain says they helped them to get this ball. So that's why we have to do something for Josh and his mother. While living with humans, Dave also has the feeling like humans. Someone has a bad attitude, and someone has turned his room into a dance club. Crew number 2 has anger and emotions. Number 3 was dressed up beautifully. Because she wants to dance with the captain. Captain refuses her because he was controlling the ship means Dave. Dave was also dancing with a lady at the party. Number 3 gets hurt and leaves. The police arrest Dave in the hotel. Number 2 becomes furious due to the changed behavior of everyone. The ship joins the army and asks them to work on their mission. All the crew, even number 3, also joined with number 2. The officers were hearing aliens' conversation due to the open speaker of Dave. The police think maybe he is an alien soldier, so the police officers leave the investigation room. The new leader warns them in the ship now none will show un-alien behavior. Dave, while using his hand pistol, breaks the police station wall. He was going out from here. The police shoot at him to stop him. But no bullet affects him. An alien jumps outside the ship to avoid the new leader's wrath. The number 2 sees Josh and his mother in the police station from Dave's eye. According to his new leader, Dave moves forward to fulfill his mission. The number 2 was taking a lot of work from Josh. As a result, number 3 becomes concerned that the mission will be ruined. That's why she releases her actual captain. They were caught and were thrown out from Dave's nose. Now the tiny aliens were trying to escape from humans and dogs. They noticed a plastic bag while fighting. They were trying to reach the ship while using it as a hot air balloon. The bag got stuck in the windscreen wiper. The wiper works as a launcher, it throws them on Dave. They apologize to Captain Number 3 and say, if you will not be with me on this trip, this would not be easy. During this, they move inside the ship. Dave stops a car so its energy will not be wasted. It asks to move to Liberty Island. Josh says to his mother, Dave can't do these evil tasks, we should help him. The police get the tiny alien in the police station. That jumped from inside Dave. Seeing it, the police order Dave to follow Dave reaching the Liberty Island. The new captain orders Dave to throw orb in the water being activated, so it will collect sea salt. Meanwhile, the first captain arrives. He stops Dave from doing this. Everyone was told inside Dave the captain had taken control again. All the crew members agreed. The Ork has also fallen from Dave's grasp as a result of his fall. It ships into the water. The ball absorbs the water from the ocean. The captain tries to stop it, but he needs a lot of energy for this. He has energy now to either save the Earth or to their planet. The captain takes permission to save Earth from his crew. They all agree on it because they have learned some things from the Earth. To love and help others. Dave saves the Earth while using his energy. Dave's powers were finished and the police also arrived there. Josh was also with the police. He charged Dave quickly while using the officer's taser. As Dave gets charged, his mouth gets open like a gate. Captain and number 3 appear and tell everything about them to the police. They say, while saying goodbye to Josh's family, that we will get energy resources from another planet. But we will not harm the Earth. Hearing this, the police put the tiny alien also into the ship. Dave gets ready to go to his planet. The current flow equals WS from his body. As he moves upward, the FBI arrives. They put a trap on Dave from the helicopter. As the officers were about to come near them, ship's members got together into a detachable place, meaning a lifeboat. It was Dave's shoe. Now they leave while starting their rocket. Only ship and number 2 are left in front of them. They left them. The captain proposes number 3 in the lifeboat. Subscribe for more videos like this.